I mean, the previous class we discussed about the definition of BI system. So what is that definition? BI system is a data warehouse system and decision support system. Am I correct? Hello.
Yes.
The functionalities. So not a problem, Joachim. No need to mute, okay? The functionalities of the BI system are ETL. So we discuss this. E stands for extraction, T stands for transformation, L stands for loading.
Loading.
Right. So totally we discussed 2 points in the previous classes. Today we are going to start with the architecture diagram of a BI system. Right. Now see. See the diagram. What are the functionalities we have? Extraction, transformations, and
loading.
Loading. Right. So on the top of that we have data sources. Right. SAP applications as well as non-SAP applications. Now see, the first point will be the source system. So okay, first point is a source system. So we have two different types of sources, okay? One is SAP sources, second one is a non-SAP sources. So BI system supports two different types of sources. One is SAP sources and second one is a non-SAP sources. Example for these SAP sources are SAP ECC. Example for the non-SAP sources are like a flat file, like databases, like ETL systems or XML systems. It's okay. So these are the examples of the non-SAP sources, etc. Now coming to second point, see the diagram. Right, second point is a interface. Right, so first step is the data sources. We discussed like SAP application data sources, non-SAP application data sources. The second point will be interfaces. Right. So what is that interface? So yesterday we discussed some point. So this is a source and here we have the data warehouse. If you want to connect the source to data warehouse, we require what? Interfaces. So interfaces are mandatory in the BI. Okay, it's very simple. If you want to connect SAP related sources, we require SAP interface. Non-SAP sources, we require non-SAP interfaces. So depends on the source system.
Excuse me for now. Did you say interface is not required in BI?
It's required, not required.
It's required. Okay.
Mandatory, it's required.
Okay.
Right. So second point, interface. So depends on the sources, we have the interfaces. So see, now requirement is to extract the information from SAP sources, we require SAP interface. The name of the SAP interface, we are calling it as a BAPI. BAPI stands for Business Application Programming Interface. Second point, non-SAP interface. Example of this non-SAP interface. For example, see, I want to extract the information from the flat file. Okay, we are going to call that interface as a flat file source system. I want to extract the information from the databases, database table. It's okay. Following, I want to extract the information from the database table. We are going to calling it as a DB Connect. DB stands for Database Connect. Now, ETL systems, we are calling it as a UD Connect. UD stands for Universal Data Connect. I want to extract the information from XML systems, the name itself as XML. Okay. So these are the interfaces and these are the sort systems we have in the real world. Got it? It's very simple. See, I want to extract the information from the SAP ECC system. What is the interface for that? For SAP ECC?
BAPI.
BAPI is the interface. Flat files, flat file sort system. Databases, DB Connect. ETL systems, Universal Data Connect. XML systems, XML. It's okay? Right. Now see, first step is completed, sort system. Second step is also completed. Now coming to third step. What is the third step? Data warehousing is the third step. Okay? So see the data warehousing, how many components are there in the data warehouse? What is the first one? PSA, right? Yes, Yaki? PSA, right? All the interfaces are connected to what?
To PSA.
PSA. On the right hand side we have master data, on the left hand side we have ODS objects, on the back end we have cube, and yellow strip we have something like open hub services, right? Totally how many components in the open data warehousing? Totally 5 components. One is a PSA, master data, ODS objects, cubes and open hub services. Clear? Hello?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Okay, fine. Just I'm waiting for your answer. Okay, fine. So now, third point. So third point is a data warehousing. It's important. Okay, just try to concentrate here. Data warehouse. Data warehouse contains how many? 5 totally. One is a PSA. Next one is a master data. Next one is a DSO. Next one is a info cube. Finally, we have open hub services or open hub destinations, not an issue. So, okay? Yeah, see, the first point is a PSA. So, what is this PSA? What is the use of this PSA here? PSA stands for Persistence Staging Area. Okay? Second one. So, what is the use of PSA here? Right, I'll explain some example for this. So, we already discussed this one, again we are discussing the same thing, see, in a flat file. So what is this flat file, SAP or non-SAP? Yes?
Non-SAP.
Non-SAP, right. So I have some flat file information, it's okay. We can simply assume that this is a flat file. It contains some data, we can assume like 5 records. So how many records totally? We have 5 records. What we need to do now? We need to load these 5 records to where?
Wanna load it to the data warehouse.
Mm-hmm. Data warehouse. And finally, what we need to do after loading that? After loading the data to data warehouses, we are going to report, right? Using the BEX tool. It's a reporting. Right. So now, what is the first point? First, we need to understand the source, Yaki. So what is the type of source we took? It's a non-SAP, right? Now tell me, what is the interface for this? Yes, what is the interface? SAP interface or non-SAP interface?
No, it's a non-SAP.
Non-SAP interface. So the source is a non-SAP file. So I took non-SAP interface, right? Now, so here I'm going to write on here like non-SAP. So remember one point, Jockey, here. So whatever the source, say SAP source or non-SAP source, whatever the data, it's okay. Initially, we are loading that information to PSA only. PSA, persistence staging area, okay. So it's very simple, see. In my file, I have 3 fields, material number, material type, material color. I want to load this information to data warehouse, but my data warehouse is empty now. What I'm doing here, I'm creating the structure as same as flat file, material number, material type, material color. This point we are calling it as a data source or PSA. So remember, data source is a number of fields and PSA is a backend table. It will contain information. Clear? Any questions? For example, in my source file, I am maintaining some 10 columns, but in a data warehouse, I am maintaining only 5 columns. What is the report contains? What the report contains? Totally 5 columns only. It's a wrong report. It's not exact one, right? So we are designing the data source as same as the source structure. Okay? We are following the same order also. Material input, type and color. We are going to follow the same order. What is the data source here? So see, before data source, my data warehouse is empty. See?
Right.
My data warehouse is empty. Like this. What I am doing, what is my requirement? I want to load this information, file records to data warehouse. If the data warehouse is empty, how can I load the file records? Right? So it's very simple. So just see, I'm throwing a ball. Okay, if you throw a ball, there is no basket, how can we catch it? Right? We require some storage location in the data warehouse. Then only we can load the information. Same example here, right? So for to maintain this information, I am going to design some structure here as same as the source. This structure, we are calling it as a data source. Okay. The structure, we are calling it as a data source, PSA.
Okay.
So data source is a number of fields. PSA, it's a table. It will store the data. Clear?
So data source is the number of columns?
Yes, number of columns. You can simply remember like a structure. For example, if my source contains 10 columns, how to design my data source? With how many columns in my data source?
In this case, 3.
Sorry?
In this case, 3.
No. For example, in my source file, I have 10 columns. Okay? In my source file, I have 10 columns. What is my data source? I'm going to design a data source with how many fields?
10 fields.
10? It's very simple. Just look at the source. The source contains number of fields. I'm going to design the same number of fields in the data source level also. Why same number of fields? So what is the use of this BI tool? What is this BI? To maintain data, right? And report, am I correct?
Both, yeah.
To maintain information and to create a report. 2 points. User is expecting report on what? The file records, am I correct?
Right.
User is expecting a report on these file records and how many columns they are expecting.
3.
So I want to make a report with 3 columns with 5 records. That is my requirement. Okay. So that's the reason I am designing the data source with the 3 columns. Okay. So data source, it's a source for data. You are designing the data source with the same number of columns as source file. If you take a different columns, data load will be a failure. Different order, failure. So we need to design the data source as same as source.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yes, now, you have any now? So what was the problem? Why you are not getting here? Yes?
Yeah,
tell me, Jyoti, where you are getting difficulty? Mm-hmm. Hello.
Did you say the level of difficulty around the...
No. I'm not asking. I'm just asking you what was the problem. I mean, where you are getting stuck. The third point is clear or not? The data source point.
You know, I really don't want to ask too much at this point because you mentioned at the beginning that we are zooming for this exhibit.
Mm-hmm.
There's no existing data in the data warehouse.
Yes.
So I could have asked, what if there's existing data in there? So the data source area has to conform to what was existing in the data warehouse.
Okay.
So say there's 10 columns there and you're bringing in a data that's like three columns, so there would be some add columns there or skip columns. I don't know where it is in data
So
warehouse.
that's totally depends on the requirement. Data warehouse is not a small storage location. It's okay. Here we can maintain some years of information, like some crores of data. It's okay. See, data warehouse is not right. This is not a useful for only one data model. It's for multiple data loads. For example, see, I have this requirement also, like customer information, customer type, customer address, and customer mobile number. Yes. So we can maintain multiple data models in a data warehouse. Got it?
Right.
So this is not a small, it's not a small location. It's a big one. We can maintain multiple data loads here. See, I'll show you practically. So this is SAP logon pad. So this is BI server. See the BI data warehouse. So see, these are all the data models. I'll show you practically. If you select it, right click display data model, display data flow. See that? This is one data flow. Okay? You can select this and right click display data model. This is one flow. Right click display data flow. This is one flow. So in the data warehouse, we are maintaining n number of data models. This is not for one data flow. You can take 3 or 4 or 5 or anything, n number of data models. It will support multiple applications and it will support multiple data models. It's okay? Right. So data warehouse is empty, meaning is, right? So why I'm saying my data warehouse is empty? It doesn't contain the same columns. It contains some other data. Okay. For example, in the real world, we have different types of applications like materials management applications, sales and distribution applications, finance applications, controlling applications, PP applications, PM applications, like that. We have n number of applications. Okay. So data warehouse contains MM information, but not the ST information. So what we need to do? Just we need to design some data model to load the information to data warehouse. Okay, so depends on the requirement, especially depends on the requirement. So my requirement will be like, I want to maintain some material number, okay, I want to maintain material number, material type, and material color, okay. So in my source, what is my requirement? My requirement is to load 3 columns with 5 records. That means my data warehouse contains some other information, but these 3 columns, 5 records are not available in my data warehouse. So what I am doing here, I am going to select the interface now. So it's a non-SAP source, I am going to choose non-SAP interface. And third point, so in my data warehouse, there is no 5 records. So 5 records means, see, material number 1, material color, green, material type, it's a raw material. Material color, green. So this is first record. Second record, it's a finished product. It's a red. Third one, it's a semi-finished product.
Okay.
It's a blue. Like that, I have some fourth record as well as like fifth record. It's okay. So these 5 records are not available in the data warehouse. So that's why I'm saying my data warehouse is empty with this data. Okay. I want to load these 5 records to data warehouse. If we want to load these 5 records to data warehouse, we require some structure. Then only we can load the data. Without structure, it's not possible to load the data to data warehouse. So what is that structure? My source contains 10 fields. I'm going to design my data source with the same number of fields. Material number, material type, and material color. For example, if my source contains 10 columns, I'm going to design my data source with the same number of columns. So okay. Clear now? Yes. Yes, okay. Any questions?
I'm looking at this picture here.
Mm-hmm.
And now you define the structure of data in the data warehouse.
Mm-hmm.
So are this like metadata?
So metadata is entirely different. So I'm not going to touch you all the things here. Just I'm explaining the basic data model. Very basic. So data warehouse, see how many components are there in the data warehouse? These are all the components of data warehouse. PSA, master data, DSOs, cubes, open hub services. In that we have different types of cubes, different types of DSOs, different types of master data objects. It's okay?
Yes.
Data warehouse is not a small location, it's a big. It contains multiple things.
Okay.
So what is the requirement? I want to load some the file records. If you want to load a file records with three columns, I'm going to design the same structure in my data warehouse. Then only I can extract the information. It's okay. Following or not, Jogi?
I am.
Mm-hmm. So this is very, very simple concept, okay? So what I'm doing here, just I'm going to create a file now, like material number, material type, and material color.
Okay.
File records. It's a flat file. Now, what I'm doing, just I'm going to select the interface now. It's a non-SAP interface. Third point. What I'm doing, just I'm going to create a data source with the same number of columns as a file. Material number, material type, material color. So this is a data source or PSA. Now, so remember this PSA is a temporary storage. We are not going to maintain the data more than 7 days. This is a temporary storage. So reporting is not possible on this particular temporary storage. We have something called target. It's okay. We are designing the target with the same number of fields, the three fields only. Right? Totally how many steps so far we covered? The first one, source. Second point, interface. Third point, data source, PSA. So what is the fourth point? Target. So remember, reporting is possible only on the targets, not on the PSAs. Reporting is always possible only on the targets. So target also we are designing with the same number of fields, number, type and color. You are designing the data source with the three fields and target with the three fields. Okay. For example, see if I design the data source with the two fields, what will happen? I am designing data source with the two fields. What are the two fields? Just I am designing the target, material number and material type. But I am expecting the material color in the report. If I create a report on this target, the report contains how many fields?
Huh.
If I create a report on this target, my report contains two fields only. What about the color? Yes, Jackie, following?
I'm here. I'm right here. Hello?
Hello.
Okay.
So Jogi, just I'm asking you, my requirement will be, I want to create a report with three columns with five records. This is my output. I want to present report with three columns with five records. If I design a data target with two columns, my report also contains two columns. Is it correct report or incorrect data? Three columns in my report. I think you have experience on the reporting, right? I think you
yes.
worked on crystal reports, I think so, right?
Right.
So simply, so for example, in the report, whatever the required columns, we are going to drag and drop. We are going to insert the columns and we are going to save and executing, right? So here just my requirement will be, so you are creating the reports on what? Some databases, right?
Yes.
So how the data will be coming to the databases? That is different. So that's the topic we are discussing now. Right. Now see. So jogging my report, I want to see three columns with five records in my report. Now tell me how to load this information to data warehouse. I want how many columns? Three columns and five records. I'm designing my data target with the two columns. If I create a report on this data target, how many columns in my report?
Same number of columns.
Material number and material depth, totally two. Is it correct report or incorrect report?
Incorrect.
So that's the reason, that's the reason I'm trying to say. If source contains three columns or four columns or 10 columns, you're going to follow the same structure here. Just I'm not, so here also I'm creating the target with the same three fields and I'm creating the report on this target. Now my report contains how many?
Three.
Got it now? Simple.
So is this like a notion of what goes in goes out?
So my strong suggestion, Jockey, just try, don't compare to other modules. BA is different, other modules are different. So don't try it. I mean, just I'm asking, just try to understand the concept in the BI. In the BI, totally we are maintaining the information and we are creating the reports. If you compare the same reporting with some other tools, definitely you may get some confusion here. It's okay. Totally two things. Remember these points. Totally two things we are doing here. One is a data maintenance. And second one is a reporting. We are maintaining the information into data warehouse. And finally, we are creating the reporting by using the tool called BEX. We're going to do only two things here, maintenance and reporting. Then get a data warehouse. What is meant by data warehouse mainly? The definition?
To house data.
It will maintain some information, right? We are calling it as a historical data. We are going to maintain some years of information into data warehouse. Am I correct?
Right.
Right. How it is maintaining the data? It's a storage location. So see, for example, I have a database table. Okay. I have a database table. I have some table. Okay. I want to maintain some data. I want to load some data to the table. Okay. Following or not?
Do you mind repeating that? I want to get a better understanding of it.
Sorry?
Do you mind repeating it? I want to make sure I get a better understanding.
So see, this is a table, it's okay?
Yeah.
I want to load some data to this table. I want to load this data. What about data? For example, see, for example, so see, just I'm not going to touch the terminology here. For example, this is like a storage location. You can say like a some, what can say, like some building. It's okay. This is a building. Totally it contains three floors. Okay. My requirement will be just try to store red balls into third floor, blue balls into second floor and green balls into first floor. I mean the ground 1, 2. It's okay. I'm loading the information. So that means I'm going to load the red balls to red, blue to blue and green to green. Got it now? For example, I'm not going to follow the same order. Just now I took some order like this. Red, green and blue. Now tell me, if I load this information like this, like red to red, green to green, green to blue, blue to green. This order is correct or failure?
Failure.
It's incorrect, right? So like database tables also, this is a table. It contains some columns. Okay, it contains some columns. For example, this is a sorts. This also contains some columns. Okay. So what is our requirement? Material number, material type, material color. Okay. So here I'm going to maintain the material number in the first case and material color in the second, material type in the third. Now tell me, if I load the information from the source to data warehouse, if this data load is success or failure? Same case, right? We are maintaining material number to number, type to color, color to type. Is it correct or incorrect?
Incorrect.
Incorrect. Why? Because we are not maintaining the same structure. We are going to load some information. Like this, you can assume like it's a blue, it's a green. Right? This is not compatible. If you are loading the data, data load is going to say it's a failure. It's going to highlight with error. You are just doing some mistake like that. It's okay? Clear? Okay, so remember one thing here. It's okay. Always data warehouse is a table. I'm going to explain the same concept again. Green, blue, red, yellow. It's okay. I have totally four colors. I have totally 25 balls or 20 balls. Each color have 4, okay? Green 4, blue 4, red 4, sorry, 5. Green 5, blue 5, red 5 and yellow 5. It's okay? So this is like some bucket or something like that. So this is an empty one. I want to maintain these 4 balls, I mean the 20 balls with 4 colors into separately into this bucket. How to divide? How many columns we need to divide? So totally how many columns now? How many area?
Yeah.
I mean how many states here?
There are 5 here.
1 for green, 1 for blue, 1 for red and 1 for yellow. Clear? If I create more than 4, what we are doing now? Just we are going to waste our space. So better to divide that bucket with the required number of columns. Now what I'm doing, I'm going to store this green color balls into one area, blue color balls into one area, red color balls into one area and yellow color balls into one area. Got it now?
Yeah.
So what I'm doing in my source, I mean in my hand, I have 4 colors with 20 balls. I want to store that these 20 balls with 4 colors into some location. Green to green, blue to blue, red to red, yellow to yellow. If I store green colors into some red color, what is it? It's a incorrect, it's mismatching. For identifying the balls is little bit difficult. We are going to search for that. Got it? It will take some more time. If I store the green balls into green bucket, we can easily pick up the required ball. If we store the blue to blue, simple. Red to red, yellow to yellow. If I store green to yellow, to search, to find out the green ball from the yellow bucket will take a long time. It's okay? In the same order, data warehouse also, see, this is my source file. This is what? Source. Material number, material type, and material color. Now tell me, this is my data warehouse. How many ways I'll divide it? How many columns I divide it? How many rows? How many columns? Material number for 1, material type for 2, material color for 3. Done? Material number here, material type, and material color. So I'm going to store the material information to material number, type to type, color to color. Is it okay now?
Yeah.
Like that. So, okay, fine. So, Jackie, do one thing today. Just try to go through this recording.